What's up, everybody? It's the kid, Bullis Gotti, man. You rocking with Rapmatics. I got the boy, Lord Jamal, in the building. Make sure y'all like, share, and subscribe. Rapmatics, salute.
Check it out, son. It's like this, then, my nigga. Hey, yo. Rich with songs, I catalog not to be touched. My rhyme book, like the book of Pili, like knife cuts. My ball slash, a fool trying to spit. They got a life of their own, yeah, they be dying to flip. The hairs on your spine stand up, you catch goosebumps. It's like a spirit in the room when that mom deep thump. PCP, the Don Perignon, rap overlord, toss your ass overboard, talk about mutiny. Scary ass gangsters, claim they gon' shoot me. Ain't too scared to go back to prison, I'm with it. It's worth every single day of them 360s. That's about 7,000 if you follow me, these bum ass niggas. All they doing is hooping on the computers. All they doing is a whole lot of hollering. Now who the F in they same mind wanna come get grazed? When they brain like Suge in that Beamer in Vegas. Hey, yo, check this out, man. It's the most infamous in a fucking America. The most infamous in the fucking world, nigga. Don't be the H-N-I-C. But right now, you're checking out Rapmatic, nigga. Get it right, nigga. Don't get it fucked up, nigga. Get it right, nigga. One.
How you feel about the whole Kanye band from the Grammys and Coachella and everything? He dropping out of Coachella and how they're feeling. And then having his documentary come out, the Genius thing, and how much he's getting praises for that documentary. You seeing his grind and seeing his underdog spirit and seeing how much he loved his mother and now everything that's affecting him now with his marriage and everything. How you feel about everything about that, Lord?
I mean, you know, I be having mixed feelings when it comes to Kanye. It's like one day you don't like him and then the next day you like him and then it's like the day after that you're not sure. It's like, you know, I don't know. Like, I really did enjoy the Genius documentary. That was dope. I think that put a lot of perspective to his mindset in a way. The shit that he's going through now, though, with his wife and his Pete Davidson and all of that, it's some weirdo shit, though. It's some sucker shit. Like, you shouldn't be going through this type of shit in the public eye. You know what I mean? Tweeting out at niggas that's, you know, fucking your wife and you calling the nigga Skeet. No, why would you? First of all, why would that be the nickname?
That's a fact.
Skeet? Do you not know what Skeet means? Like, why are you calling him Skeet as if you're disrespecting him? He's skeeting on your wife. In her, on her, all of that. Like, that's not, I don't get it. I don't know. I think it's a dose, it's a just a dose of, you know, a lot of us have indulged Kanye in a lot of ways.
Fact.
You know what I mean?
Fact.
In ways that he shouldn't have been indulged.
That's
you know?
Fact. Fact.
Like, I still can't bring myself to buy a pair of Yeezys. I'm not gonna lie.
I
just haven't done it. Like, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
But, when people do that, you know, rush out and resell these things, that's what adds the fuel to his fire. You know what I mean? It makes him feel like I am a fucking genius and I can do anything and whatever I do is right. Like, and at some point, you know, you can't have all these yes men around. Like, you gotta have somebody that pull your coat and be like, yo, bro, you bugging.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But when you get to that level of, yo, now you in that billion bracket and all of that, like, who's really around to tell you shit? You know what I mean?
Yeah, facts.
Unless it's somebody that got more money, at least as much money or more money than you, because a lot of times people translate money into intelligence and they think if they have more money than you, they're smarter than you, so they don't want to listen to you, even though that's bullshit.
Facts.
Money has nothing to do with intelligence.
That's okay.
Plenty of stupid motherfuckers could get money. You can get hit by a car tomorrow and fucking
and
get a lawsuit,
get a lawsuit.
And be rich. You know what I mean? That don't make you smart.
That's a fact. That's a fact.
But Yeah, I think he believes that he's a genius and that anything he does is right. So I don't think there's a lot of people that could tell him what to do. And if there's somebody like Jay-Z that might have, you know, you see that relationship. Because sometimes you try to tell a nigga, like you try to be that nigga that's, and then they be not fucking with you. You know what I mean? So, yeah, I mean, I try not to like dwell on a nigga too much, but his name keep coming up. And now I heard he was chilling with the nigga Pete Davidson.
Yeah. That's crazy. That's crazy.
So, and then, but why are people banning him? Yeah, they banned him from
the Grammys. Yeah, the Grammys and Coachella.
Because he's bullying this nigga?
Yeah, he bullying this nigga. That's what they said.
Like, why? Like, what is that? What do they have to do with it?
That's what I don't understand. I don't understand.
Is it because he's a white boy?
Yeah.
If he was bullying, let's say, Travis Scott.
Yeah.
Would it be the same response?
Hell no. I don't even think so. And I think, and I'm going to keep it real with you, like, when I look at the whole thing, Kanye got 2 Grammys. So not to have him near to receive his two.
And he actually got them. He wasn't just nominated.
He won. Him and Jay-Z won one. Then he won one with The Weeknd and Lil Baby. So he got 2 Grammys.
Right.
So what I don't understand, if you get nominated for 2 Grammys and then win the Grammys, you can't come to receive your awards. You just banned totally just because you bullying this dude.
Right.
That's the crazy thing I don't understand.
But then also that adds to the story.
Yeah.
You see, he won 2 Grammys that he couldn't receive.
Yeah.
Just like watch what's gonna happen with the Will Smith.
Yeah.
This nigga's gonna get nominated for some shit.
Yep.
He might fuck around and win.
Yep.
And they're gonna be like, oh, but he can't go.
He can't go.
He's banned.
Yeah.
And it's gonna add actually more attention to the fact that he won and couldn't go because of the Chris Rock shit. Like, trust me. All of this shit is hell. Like, Chris Rock's ticket sales.
It's going crazy right now. And he got a Netflix special coming, so you already know. Like, it's going
to
go crazy.
And Will Smith is about to come with I Am Legend 2.
I Am Legend 2.
With the fucking...
Michael B. Jordan. Yeah.
Nigga, banned or not, mad people's going to go see that just because of this.
Yeah.
Like, the shit he just won an Academy Award for.
Yeah.
You think that did well at the box office?
Nah.
Hell no.
Nah.
But that was the one that...
That they had to
we're going to give this the emotional one.
Yeah.
All your box office shit is never enough to get you, like, Academy Award. So we're going to give you an emotional one, but you're going to sacrifice the box office.
That's a fact.
But on this next one, watch his next ones. Watch the box office.
It's
and everybody's just gonna want to see it just because.
That's a fact.
I want to see what Will Smith does next. Watch.
Yeah.
So trust me, this shit is helpful to him. But yeah, all of this cancel culture, like, niggas got to be careful with this shit.
Because
you sign on to it, and then tomorrow it's gonna be you that they want to cancel. You know what I mean? Then what you gonna do?
That's a fact. I feel like the cancel culture today just showed that the society is soft. It's so politically correct. And that you can't even be speak your mind because you offending so many people just because you got your third eye open and everybody else is just sheep. So it's like we took the red pill and these dudes taking the blue pill over here. And then because we took the red pill, they don't want to hear what we got to say because we speaking the truth. That's just crazy.
Even though I want to speak on that red pill, blue pill real quick.
Yeah.
Because they did fuck us up with that.
Yeah.
Like, first of all, let me tell you. All right, when you deal with the chakras, right?
Yeah.
The red is the first pill, right?
Yeah, fact.
I mean, the red is the first chakra.
Yeah.
It's the foundation.
Foundation.
It deals with the lower self.
So,
then there's the orange, yellow, green, and the blue, purple, okay? So now the blue is where you speak the truth. This is why they say you're true blue. Because in order to get to that, that purple chakra, you have to have love in your heart, and you have to be speaking the truth. So, in the Matrix, they fool niggas to go back to that foundational chakra. It's really the blue pill is the one that sets you free.
Yeah.
They switched it.
I said,
these motherfuckers. So now you got motherfuckers who think they're gonna get free from choosing the red pill when that's putting you right back at the starting line.
That's a fact.
You're supposed, it's the blue pill that gets you free.
That's true.
But they switched it in the Matrix,
these
fucking bastards.
Yeah.
It's the blue pill, y'all. Don't listen to that shit. The blue pill gets you out the Matrix. That's the true blue, your blue chakra. They want to make you take the red pill, trick you to going back to fucking first grade. Fuck out of here.
Facts.
So, yes, that being said, they are trying to do that type of shit.
Yeah.
And, yeah, we can't have it, man. We got to be aware enough, educated enough to know.
Of course, of course, of course. So, yo, Lil Jamal, let me ask you, how you feel about the rap game right now? Like New York City in general, and just the whole rap game, but especially New York, because New York is crazy with the violence, with the drill rap. And then you got upstate New York with the bringing real rap back. Then you got the vets like Nas bringing classic music back to the game and getting a Grammy for King's Disease and being nominated for King's Disease too. And then bringing another classic album with Magic. How you feel about that?
I mean, you know, it's a mixed bag, like you just said. You know what I mean? There's good shit and there's, not so good shit. I mean, as far as the upstate rap and all that, I've been fucking with like Griselda and all of that for a minute. Like they've been on my radar way before niggas was really popular and all of that type of shit. Niggas like Rock Marcy and all of that, like that's my man. And you know, I'm also responsible for bringing Stove God Cooks into the game and all of that type of shit. So I already was knowing about like upstate rappers, and I always felt like hip hop was gonna come back to New York, but I said it's not necessarily gonna be downstate. Because we've told these stories many to everywhere, all the five boroughs and Westchester and all that, but we didn't hear about upstate. Hours away, but it's still in New York State. This is where niggas from down here get thrown away. That's where the jails is at. But them niggas live up there in the cold. It's a whole other kind of culture. The radio and the music. It's New York, but then it's still kind of like it's like other parts of the country too. It's like mainstream. So I was like, yo, upstate's got a story to tell, and watch, it's gonna pop. And sure enough, it did that. As far as like the Brooklyn drill shit and all of that, now, and don't get me wrong, like the upstate shit is not perfect. I like the sound, you know, that they're like the samples that they're choosing and all of that, but you know, it's a lot of drug rap and, you know what I mean? Boom, 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 and it's like, you know. We can get better with that too. Like I like the sound of it, but the message, there's a message that's missing. You know what I mean? They trying to keep it too street. Like, you know what I mean? And it's like, we have, even on the street, there's more dimensions to the street than just street shit. You know what I mean? Like, there's niggas on the street that got knowledge, and we need to hear that shit mixed in with the street shit. That's the type of shit I like. So, anyway, but now when you get to this Brooklyn drill shit, again, there's parts of it I liked. I almost predicted that sound. But I thought it was gonna be, see, when I first heard dubstep, I said, yo, this is gonna be like the niggas is gonna start rhyming to these type of beats. But dubstep was a little more slower than this, like,
got a haunting. It got
than
a
that English,
bass.
That England drill shit. Or whatever. It's a little faster, but it still has those sounds in there. And so that's what niggas ended up doing, like fucking with that faster, like almost dubstep type music. But now here they are just talking about killing each other and, you know, taunting each other when somebody get killed and all that, and just aggravating situations and shit like that. And it's like, why are we doing that?
I think when I look at the game now, right, especially with the drill scene, right, and you see what's going on, it's like, it's gotten to the point that it's getting more violent in the streets, because if you listen to the music, it's a low frequency. It's not a higher frequency, so the music is not gonna have you up. It's a downer. So the music gonna have you more down. And then if you listen to it, you can see a lot of these young boys that's out here that's listening to the music, they going and emulating what they hear from these drill raps. So now you got the mayor getting involved, the politicians getting involved, everybody saying, yo, the drill this and drill that. But when it first came out, everybody was, they was jumping on it. When Pop Smoke came out, everybody jumped on it. I remember when drill rap, with radio didn't want to play drill rap. With Hot 97, none of them wanted to touch it. The clubs was touching it, but the radio didn't want to touch it. Flex didn't want to touch
right.
it, none
and
of them.
And then Pop Smoke get killed, and Pop now everybody want to play it.
Everybody want to play it. So
yeah, what's that about? Like
that's the fake love.
It's like, but it's almost, what message does that send to the youth?
Like, facts.
Like, you make some shit and you fuck around and get killed, and that's when you could pop off.
That's when you could pop off.
You know what I mean?
But it's like
you gotta get killed in order to pop off.
Yeah, but it's like what Biggie said, you nobody till somebody kills you. That's the crazy thing.
Retarded.
That's like, retarded.
That's a retarded, that's retarded frame of mind. Like,
fact.
You know, to feel fact. Like that's true. Like,
yeah.
You know?
And it's like, you know, like, it's ill because if you look at hip-hop is one of the most, like I heard Jim Jones said it, that hip-hop is the most violent business to be in, which it is, because if you really look at it, look at how many rappers done died in the last couple years. It's, you know, and from 2020 to 2021, even 2022, rappers are still dying at a rapid pace. And it's rappers that we ain't never heard of. Some of these rappers is just fairly new coming in the game and they
getting
killed.
Sometimes I'm like, is these niggas really rappers? Are they saying these niggas? Because it's like, some of these niggas, like, where was they rapping at? Like, what, they made one tape and now you want to just put them in a category of rappers that got killed? Because some of these niggas, I'm like, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
You never heard of this motherfucker, yeah. Nowhere. Like, is he even on iTunes? Like, come
yeah,
on.
Yeah.